Hi, this is Kevin with iHost Networks, and in this video, I'll quickly take you through setting up your products and categories. So let's go ahead and get started by adding our categories first. So to do this, you'll need to press the Catalog tab at the very top, and this will immediately put you on the Categories section. So you'll see some sample categories here in the list, and you probably want to delete these and add your own. So what you need to do is select a category you don't want, and then go ahead and press the Delete button. And then to add your own categories, you need to go down here at the bottom bar and type in your new category name, and then go ahead and press the new button. So once you've done that, you'll need to create your own products. So if you're still under the catalog tab, you need to select the products link on the left. And then you'll see your sample products here. So if you want to get rid of these, you go and check mark the one that you don't want and then press the delete button. And to add your own products, you need to go up to the new product ID field and type in a new SKU number or product number, and then go ahead and press the add new product button. And then this will take you to the general info, so you'll need to give it a new product name and then a new site price here, and then go ahead and add in a short and long description. And I'll go ahead and scroll down here, and you have additional options at the bottom here, so you can go ahead and click on them, and then that will expand downward. And then once you have added all that information, just press the Save Changes button. And then once you create your own product, you'll need to assign it to a category, otherwise it won't show up. So on the left, go ahead and select Categories, and then go ahead and check mark a category you want it to show up in, and then press the Save Changes button. And then you'll need to also add an image for the product, so all you need to do is go over to the Images section here on the left, and then go ahead and press the Browse button and select an image on your computer, and then you want to set it to auto generation of all sizes, and go ahead and press the Choose this image button. And you can also add additional images by selecting that option and then go ahead and saving that. And if you'd like further information on any of these topics, you can go up to the Need Help button at the very top, and it will give you more information. All right, well, that's it. Thanks for watching.